Hello
everyone.
So,
all the judges, and then we get this back to, okay?
Hello everyone, my name is Filippo Oliveira. I hope you are doing well. Probably most of you already know me from social media, from Aquaflora, from so many aquascaping activities all over the world. And I'm also one of the judges of ANAC. ANAC is Aquaflora Nano Aquascaping Contest. This is a local contest that usually takes place in Vivarium in the Netherlands, in Rosmalen. But this year, and since we are passing through a pandemic, COVID-19, it's not possible to make it physical. So they have figured out one way just to make it online. And also this contest this year is also online. We already have the pictures of all the tanks. So it's time now just to judge, comment some of your tanks, wishing you best of luck. And then the results, of course, they will be announced in Vivari Online in 2 weeks, in November 29. Best of luck to all of you and stay safe.
Hey, Vivarium family, it's Fabi at home. Even though that year it was so difficult, we don't have the opportunity to meet in person. At least we have something nice to celebrate together. So thanks for that. As a judge, I promise to do my best. So I can't wait to see your tanks. Good luck, a lot of kisses, bye! I missed the heart.
Hi, I'm Romy Verlaan and my company is called AquaRomy. I make aquascapes, but I also give lectures and demonstrations about aquascaping. But I'm also a proud member of the Esther's Garden maintenance team. It's said that Vivarium cannot proceed in the usual way, but we have a good online alternative with a great contest. I'm honored to be a judge again. I cannot wait. Good luck to all the participants.
Hello, my name is Sascha Heuer from Germany. I'm very sad to don't can meet you personally this year on Vivarium, but I'm very happy to be a part of the judge and we can start the contest online and the complete exhibition online this year. And I hope you all stay strong, be held, and we hope to see us next year on Vivarium again in Holland. And yeah, enjoy the show. Goodbye.
Hi everyone. I am Masashi Ono from Japan. I am very honored to join as a judge of the wonderful Vivarium contest. I have been enjoying aquatic plant layouts since I was fascinated with Amano-san's nature aquarium 28 years ago. I am looking forward to meet your wonderful work. Bye-bye.
Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. Welcome to join us in this live stream, Aquaflora live stream, regarding the ANAC 2020 review about the top 10. And just before we start, I would like to explain a little bit of what is ANAC. ANAC is Aquaflora Nano Aquascaping Contest. And this year, I think, is the third edition of this contest. And due to COVID-19, we had it to do it online. Usually, what we usually do, we have the contest and people get around at Aquaflora in the end of June, beginning of July. And then after they escape the tank, because Aquaflora provide the tank, the hardscape, the plants, all they need with some support of GBL and other companies that are in the partnership with Aquaflora for this contest. They need to take the tank home, let the tank mature for 4 months, and then bring it back to Vivarium exhibition in Rosmalen in the Netherlands. This is a contest that mainly for local So people that is on surrounding from the Netherlands, from Belgium, from the Germany. We get it last year, some people from Poland, some crazy guys that travel so far away just to be in this contest. But this is not something that usually is online, like EAPLC, EIC, CLIAC from the China Aquatic Art Association. No, because a lot of people already ask how they could submit their words to the contest, but they cannot, because this is a very special project, a very special contest that is held on directly on Aquaflora. And then the idea is just to bring all those tanks that can be judged live in the exhibition in the Netherlands. So we, this year, and with COVID, we had to do it online. Big thanks to all the contestants that made this work. I don't know if it is difficult or more difficult just to bring the tank home and then bring it back, or just taking the pictures for the context. Because in general, all of these contestants, they are not used to submit their tanks to the contest. And also, since we have a very small tank, is a 40 by 30 by 30, it means that all the tanks, they need to use the same tank. And then, of course, the imagination will change everything. And of course, then live, we can just select and choose our best. I must say that probably this year, I think for most of us, and I think the Alpha Aquaflora, I can say that it was an amazing result. We are not definitely not expecting, because if the people are not used to taking the pictures, probably it's much easier for them, because some of them, they already did this contest in the previous edition. So bring the tank home and being visible during all the exhibition. But I must say that all the pictures were spot on. The guys did an amazing job. And I think this is a step up. So maybe next year we can see a lot of interest in international contests, because after this part, or this small part of entrance in the aquascaping contest, I think that will open a lot of doors. And this is what we expect, just to inspire and also have more people around in the contest. And also they can just improve their skills and try to give a step up in the other contest. So let me have Romy and also Bobby to talk about the ranking of ANAC 2020. Girls, how are you doing?
Great.
I'm so happy to see you.
So
hi all.
In person for a long, long time.
Hi to all.
To travel, so usually we only do some live stream together, talking about a lot of stuff, and also, of course, we see Romy taking care of the Estes Garden. Also with the LA and Sam, they are doing an amazing job over there. As you guys may know, I cannot travel from Portugal. Things are getting really difficult over here. And I think, I really hope that in January we can just travel back, and I'm very looking forward to come back. But also, this doesn't mean that Romy will be dismissed, so she can keep doing the job.
I still have a lot of things. So, like I say, thank you so much.
So guys, let's get started with the tanks, because I think we have some amazing words just to show. I think for mostly of them, the guys that were already in the competition, they already know the results, because the results were announced last Sunday during Vivarium Online. Because this year, not having the normal Vivarium exhibition in Rosmalen, I think that the staff, and I think we need to give a big applause to all of them for all the effort, everything they have done for the hobby, and just to make it possible and make this weekend so cozy. So we can just, we cannot be there, but at least we were seeing on the TV. Of course, Romy was there, because Romy is from the Netherlands. But me and Bobby, we were just watching from the TV. And
yeah, we saw from the distance
what it was going on Estes Garden. And guys, it was a really an amazing job, Vivarium. Congratulations. Wow. And of course, Romy, you did also an amazing job with the workshops in the Wabi Pusa. And also,
God, everything. What happened, Felipe?
Let's move on.
So nice.
we have, thanks to just check, let's kick this one with Bobby. Should be or not?
What should be? To start?
Yes.
Do you want to start?
Want to
no. No. So all of you know perfectly how shy I am. So
okay, no worries. I will ask Romy just to say the name of the contestants. Because even after being working on Aquaphor for a couple of years, I think 6 years, my Dutch is still not that
okay,
good.
But
so
I think you have to try, Filip.
It's
Mark Jan Fiole.
Yeah, Mark Jan Fiole.
Okay.
Ah, nice.
So this is a 10th place. And I think it's better to say hi to everybody that is seeing us from Facebook and also from YouTube.
Yeah, so many
also,
people here.
Yeah, there's a lot of people seeing it. That is really, really nice. So let's kick this contest and the reviews about this tank. Do you want to start, Bobby, Romy, me?
No, I don't want to start.
At first?
I told you, I don't want to start.
Okay, we can do it all together. Okay.
Yeah.
Think... all together, nobody will understand what we're saying. So someone
get it at the same time.
We move forward. Hello. Come on, let's go.
Okay.
Come on, Romy.
I think the plants look healthy. But I think there's a little bit of BBA on the stones. Maybe I'm wrong.
Yes. Yeah. I have noticed that too.
Okay. Too bad for BBA, but and the hardscape, I think it looks better if it's a little bit more out of the center, the focus point, like more asymmetrical.
I must say that I get what the Mark tried to do over here. This is like a V-shaped composition with a rock just placed there. Where are we going to see the stem plants coming from the corners? It's good to say that to everybody that they have more or less 4 months to mature the tank before they take the final picture or bring the tank to the Vivarium exhibition in Rosmalen. Because I already explained before, the end or the kickoff is end of June, beginning of July. And then usually Vivarium is the end of November. So they have more or less 4 months to mature the tanks. And also to present a mature tank to the exhibition. So for this one, I think it was just a question of managing a little bit the time and the trimming, because the plant should grow a little bit more on the corners just to hide and also to make the composition in a V shape. Of course, there is some PDAs on that. When I was judging the tank, I saw it clearly, but somehow they disguise a little bit with the rocks. I would say that he was lucky probably for him just because those rocks are a little bit porous. And then by having a little bit of BBA on that, it's not completely visible on the picture. But of course, for my part, it was deducted a little bit of points on that, but taking in consideration the general composition of the aquascape, the only thing that he needs a little bit more time. Probably he didn't manage completely the time for the trimming and also to have the sides completely full in order to have the best impression of it. But in general, the tank looks good. We need to have in mind, those are all obvious. They are not used to submit tanks for the contest. And
That is so important to tell you.
Yeah, because people will try to understand and try to compare this contest with the other ones that we have, like YAPLC, ISTA, CLIAC, ECO. But it's not the same. This is a local contest, guys. And of course, OBI is still growing and aquascaping is still growing in the Netherlands, also in Belgium. We are seeing a lot of upcoming aquascapers in the hobby. That is amazing and also very, very good. And I think each year that passed, the results are much, much better. This one, I must say that was a little bit difficult to judge. However, the top five, I think in general, we almost agree more or less, some position, less position, but we almost agree on that. But it was difficult. So
it was so different.
Yeah, do you want to say something about this one? Or
I'm agree. I completely agree with you both, but I think that the thing that Romy told about the weight of the composition, it would be so different if the rotor latitude would be much bigger, you know, on the left.
This is what I said. Yeah. They get the ball in the corners.
Yeah.
They have the V shape, empty area that will be the vanishing point on the center, and that will also improve. Of course, it's too centered. It should be a little bit more one side or the other. But anyway, in general, it's a really nice composition. I like it. The problem of the algae, but still okay.
The size of the aquariums are a little bit weird because small. It's 40, 30, so it's almost
small. The thing is, most of the aquascapes that we're going to see, they look really bigger. And they look like 40 by 30 by 30. So the tanks are not that big, guys. So just give this impression by using small plants. Always try to make the tank huge. And also the picture is quite nice too, because we asked them, they should not edit the picture. It was not allowed. So they need to take the picture, just crop and send it to us. And in general, the tank looks good despite the part of the algae.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure that if it was algae free, this tank would score a little bit higher.
Yeah.
So just move to the next one. Oh, no, sorry. This one. This is from Bruno Collet.
Bruno Collet.
From Belgium.
Yeah.
So I think
Bruno
or Bobby, you should start now and say something about this.
For me, the tank is the perfect way to play with the space, because you can see that it's tiny. That tank is so tiny, and he play very well with the planos, Felipe. You know,
you need the different layers.
Yeah.
Different layers.
Yeah, I think he played very, very well with the layers. And for sure it's a bit, Bruno, I think it's a bit mess with everything, but I love the way that you did that hardscape. But I like it so much. And I feel so sorry because I cannot explain myself very well doing that kind of things. So I'm so sorry.
No, but if you have any issues, you can always say in Spanish. Yeah. I will try to translate somehow.
Yeah.
So Romy, do you want to say something about it?
Yeah, I agree with Balbi, of course. But it's a very interesting hardscape. I don't think you see it very often. And you also see that the plants are healthy and have been there for a long time. They're very they have a natural growth.
I think the part of that Bobby was saying a little bit clumsy, a little bit in the very wild way. Mm-hmm. Also, I think it gives a special touch to the layout, because sometimes some layouts, when mostly we don't have some straight lines or lines that usually fall one direction, it means that when we place in kind of abstract way by just adding some plants a little bit overgrowth, and also the mix, when they tend to mix a little bit, you always give a little bit more natural feeling to the layout. The only thing that I'm missing in this layout is the position of a very strong focal point. We can see some rotala reds from the red from the right and the left point. You can see a little bit more on the shadow. So my eyes are always pointing for that corner. So the better way is just to take all those rotalas from there and just place it probably one third. Could be just a tiny top of the plant, just give you a little bit of the shape, will enhance a little bit more the layout itself, and then all the other lines we don't care that much, because we have always a very distinct focal point where to look first, and in this way all the wood is placed in different directions, we can a little bit lose in the aquascape. However, I do agree that the lines are pointing mostly to the left side, and having this first part just pointing a little bit on the on the right and also upwards, always kind of it makes sense. So, but in general, the only thing that I would like to be changed on this layout that could be improved is just removing those reds from the sides and just place it 1/3, and probably the tank will look much, much better.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's move forward to the next one.
Let's go.
So we have this one from John Quinman. I think it's Ferdy. Ferdy?
Yeah.
The name of the guy.
Picture is amazing.
I know him. Oh, of course, I know most of all of them that they already submitted their tanks for the contest. I'm not getting younger, so sometimes my memory just miss a little bit here and there. But okay. But I remember Freddy mostly because of last year. And let me kick off with this one because it was my favorite on the competition. This one, and I like it very much because it's more or less my own style. And why? Because I like to see all those very well trimmed bushes of the stem plants on the corners. It tends to mix up a little bit the air grass with I think it's Niento Scuba that he has on the sides. Tripartita is doing an amazing job, just bringing us to the front, and then in somehow. Making your eyes going backwards, but the only thing that is missing here is a little bit more volume on the corners and make the shape a little bit better. That will change completely the composition. But for me, it is very impressive. They did a really amazing job with this one.
Yeah, I miss a little bit more hardscape or more no more definition because he did that work with the plants. So he did it very, very, very well. So congrats. But I miss some hardscape to help that shapes. You know, it's the only thing
You don't have more a plant geek than a hardscape. So for me, more plants the better.
I love it.
I think if you have a little bit more height difference, then it would look even better. But it's already... very nice.
I think the only thing that was missing to Ferdy was just bringing the corners and making the shape more in the valley, just enhance a little bit more the shape. But it's an amazing job. And the picture.
Yeah, it is, definitely. Is but
yeah, the picture it's with almost the water movements. Yeah.
Yeah, it's one of the best ones. But for me, it's the same that you told before about the... the hardscape
focus point
for you, yeah,
for the focal point,
yeah. I think that it's
but we have a
almost
focal
the same,
point.
But
you have
with
a rock on the floor. You have the
no,
but it's a little bit too much in the center. A little,
you can see that for the we are how many judges? Six.
Mm-hmm.
We are six, right?
That me, that is you, nice that you can, yeah.
Me, you, Romy,
please explain.
Masashiono, Esther, and also Sasha. So. Guys, no matter what discussion we can have, because it is good in this way because each one has more or less a personal opinion about the layout. Of course, some will please more than others to some, of course. And this is why the argument and doing this live stream with two different opinions, because I know what Bob is like. I know also Romy quite well.
Yeah, you know so everything.
I think somehow I'm going for all the mix, and then we have Romy that mix a little bit less, and Bobby go for the minimalism. It's always like that. So it's very difficult to please the three at the same time.
But it was so curious because in that contest, the different taste, it was so high. More than the professional contest ones, you know?
It was even tough because, of course, I think the top three, top four, they were more or less unanimous for everyone. Yeah. But then they changed a little bit the position. But then we had that they up and down so fast because some will love it, others, they like probably other tanks. But in the end, it's all a matter of taste, so guys. There is never a lose. There is always something that is very difficult to please everybody. So, Freddy, that was an amazing job. Like all the others in the 10th position on the top 10 all did an amazing job, but the only thing is a matter of taste. So people like more than others. So ranking can change. I think the only one that probably we didn't disagree that much was on the top three. I think more or less on the top three, we didn't disagree that much. So this one from Bastian, Romy, you can just go with it.
Okay, okay. I just love the plants. There are so many plants and they look so healthy. It's kind of a healthy jungle and I just love that. And I love the contrast with the dark rocks and the light sand.
Yeah, and the picture are so nice. And it looks much bigger. I miss a little bit, not order, but yeah, a little bit more order, but I love that tank. For sure, it's so nice. It looks much, much bigger than the size that it is. Yeah.
So I have
I love that one.
I have a different opinion on this one.
For sure.
Yeah, I have a different opinion on this one, because and in this tank, I think the way how it was, the plants were a little bit mixed together. Some of them they were not just in the perfect position. And I think this tank, like so many others in the contest, they need a little bit more time just to get some definition of the areas that you want to point out. It looks very natural in how it is. I'm not saying that it's not. I'm saying that it needs definition in some parts because, for example, the stem plants that are on the background, we can see just a little bit, but just let them grow probably 4-5 centimeters more, we're going to enhance a triangular shape and make it this layout, I think, more pleasing to the eye. I know that it was unanimous for a lot of them that they really liked this tank. I'm not saying that was is bad. No, it's, I like the tank. I need is a lack of definition in some of the plants.
Yeah. No. I agree. Maybe I didn't explain myself. Okay, but. The point is that you have no idea. It's everything is looks natural, but yeah, it needs time, definitely. That kind that content it is it's like this, you don't have more time.
There is something there that distract me a little bit. I understand the flow, I understand completely the idea. I think it needs a little bit more of time just to grow, just to probably. Guys, this is one thing, because on picture we can see one tank and it looks completely different live. I'm pretty sure that if you have seen this tank directly in Rosmal in exhibition, probably some of the ranks would change, because seeing a tank live is completely different from the picture.
Sure.
I don't know the guys that they are seeing, because taking a picture to a tank probably is one of the most difficult things to do. The angle, how we capture the distance, everything. We need to take some time just to take some pictures time to time, just to see how they look like, how we evolve. Okay, so let's move forward.
Let's go.
Nice. Bobby is one of your favorites, you told me. So let's go.
I love that one. So you cannot find the end of that tank. Mm-hmm. I know the picture is not, maybe it's not the best one, but if you have on mind the size of that tank, so you cannot find the end. And so you have the natural feeling. I love the simplicity of everything. At the same time, you have a lot of hardscape. So for sure that you know my taste.
Yeah, I know.
And
Romy,
yeah, I love that one. Congratulations, Mark. I love it.
I also like it. I like it there is a lot of shadow, and the plants that are in there, just the moss and the Anubias, it just looks good. And again, a big contrast: the light sand and the shadows, the dark driftwood, dark rocks.
I am always
for sure.
Let me tell what when I look at the tank, what I feel it. You saw the last one from Bastian. Mm-hmm. We have very tiny wood that will follow more or less the shape of the plants, and it makes some sense. Here, knowing the tank is very small, probably the wood is so thick and it's so volume that somehow it takes and make the tank too full. And also, for example, if the moss was more slightly to the wood, it was just trimmed, probably we would get a little bit more on the contrast of the wood. This is my opinion about the scape. I'm not saying I like the shape. I like the simplicity. I think that some parts of the wood should be a little bit more naked. And then also, if we take a little bit of the volume that we already have on the wood by the moss, the wood would not look so thick, and somehow the tank will be a little bit more wide, not so full. And this is what I think about. I like it, the composition. I like the idea. However, it's still too full for such small tank. I think just trimming the moss will reduce a little bit the volume. You still have the contrast, the green, the shadows, everything. But trimming a little bit the moss will reduce more or less 1/10 probably of the volume and will look much better.
Do you guys agree? I agree.
That is fine. That's okay. 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 So let's move on to the next one. So about this one.
We are doing so well, eh? We are agreeing.
So let's talk about this one. So shall I talk first? No, I think you should do it. I am already talking too much. And we already, you have more or less 1 hour to the live stream.
No, but I think for me it's not a problem, and I think for Romy maybe either.
No, Romy, it's but okay, not a problem Romy. Too. And I'm pretty sure that in half an hour the alarm will start ringing over here. My dog will start laughing so much, barking and making a lot of noise. But I will, if I switch off my mic, you already know what it is. So let's move on. Let's talk about this one. What do you like on it? Can I talk? Because it was also one of my favorites in the competition. Because you know that I like to mix a lot of plants, right? The thing is here, the plants are mixed somehow. It looks nice and colorful, but without not losing too much the focal point and the color that we have on the right side. And we have clear lines pointing front and down the left side. So somehow the composition is a fake triangular shape, but with the very good lines and vanishing point, just moving from like a wave coming from the backwards to the front. I like the textures. I simply take some deduction on the points because some plants are simply placed in the wrong position. I don't know if it was made on purpose just to give sense of depth. But I think, for example, we have some cryptocoryns just behind the Amania Golden. And this not make any sense knowing the size that usually Amania Golden will get in the future. So that will be completely covered. But somehow, I don't know also if they were stick in the tank just before taking the picture, somehow just to readjust and making the color. But in general, composition, I think it looks quite nice. I like it.
Yeah, it looks nice.
Yeah.
For me, the idea it's so nice because you have a lot of texture, a lot of colors. The shadow on with the boot are so nice. The way that the plants are taking place on the boots too. So you have the back part with some Cuba or Monte Carlo. I'm not sure, but. Yeah, well, for sure. It needs time. It's the problem with that contest. It's that one. You have have more. Yeah.
Yeah, it's only 4 months, and so you know that some plants take a little bit more time to mature than others, and of course, even for us, that we kind of expertise, so we know how to trim it, I know how to fix it, and know exactly the time that we need to take just to get the proper volume. And for example, if you start trimming and you still don't have the time enough just to make it full, so you can always miss a little bit the timing just to take the picture. But somehow, I really love this aquascape in the way how it is done. The detail, the shadow, all the shapes, I think it makes a lot of sense on it. So let's move to the next one.
No, Romy, you don't.
I also agree. There's a lot of textures, a lot of color, but you have a good focal point. So it's not too messy. It's interesting, but not too messy, I think.
Yeah. I think in general, Frank, I would say the last name.
Vught.
I will never get that.
Frank
you know that I only know kroketten, bitterballen. So this is very difficult. Mooi, Guten Morgen. So
Vught.
Some names are very
You have
difficult.
To try the Dutch. Frank Vught.
So let's move on. Let's go for the fourth place, and we have here Susie. I think is the first time that she submits something for a contest, right?
Yeah,
I think that it's so important to know, because a lot of people that is taking part of that contest.
Yeah.
Maybe it's the first time, the second escape that they did. So we need to.
No, they actually did it really, really well. Guys,
definitely.
I'm really happy to see all the results and also all the effort that you guys took just to make it happen. And also all of the demands in the end, just requesting some videos like you guys are going to see in the end of this one. By Sam talking about the escape. Some of them already sent some videos. And I think it is behind our expectations regarding what we could expect from all of them. They did an amazing job. And so, Bobby, you want to kick it off? And
I cannot say anything wrong, because if you have in mind that she's first escape. What I can say? Congratulations,
no,
Susie.
It's not the situation of being the
I cannot say. Yeah, yeah, I love the way that she played with the shadows for sure. Mm-hmm. So for me, it's crazy. For the
we should not consider this is the first or the second one.
Yeah, but I cannot do that.
We cannot give extra points because of the time they are on aquascaping. So we should value all the tanks by the same. So it's looked by the appearance, healthy of plants, then general composition, algae free. So for this one, Romy, do you want to say something else?
I really like that the focal point is not in the center.
Mm-hmm.
And a great use of shadows, great details in the front, a good use of height. And I also think I cannot say something bad.
No, but because when we vote, we didn't know if that time it was for Susie or not.
No,
At least I didn't know.
No,
because I didn't check anything before on ANAC. So I didn't check anything.
I was the only one getting and seeing those pictures over and over and over and over again. So I had a more or less a clear mind, because I had to make all this design and making the videos for announced to be party online. And of course that by making all those designs and taking the time, I took, I would say, I looked to them in a very, very different way and start looking more to the details. And also because in this video, we don't have the plant list. However, then I will share on Aquaflora Facebook a video where we have the plant list and each contestant. So you can just make a pause and see all the plants that they have used. And for this one, for me, I think is probably one of the few diorama aquascapes that came on this contest. because this kind of resembled me like a mountains. We have really nice shadows somehow, and it's like a tree that we have on the left side, but the general composition itself, it does not become too distracting. I think in general, everything for the small details try to match perfectly it somehow. So, of course, for my personal taste, there is always a missing a little bit here and there. But for example, the way we finish just a little bit more, or here the Leocar is just to, okay, give a little bit more details, because I think for the more details we can give an aquascape, more time we spent watching it and try to understand how it was made. And also, I believe those Rutalas, they are one third of the scape. Because I remember to see something in a group, because we have an art group where they could always ask, not showing their work, but asking for some advice and expertise in something. And then somehow I remember Susie was trying to get the best result from the reds, and I think he couldn't achieve it. Otherwise, those plants there, probably they will get a very amazing shape and they'll look amazing on there. But it's still a very good job. Not my favorite on the style, but this doesn't mean that it's not okay. For me, is well done in the way it is. I always tend to go more in the last couple of years for more for the natural layout with more mixed plants.
Yeah. Do you remember your first aquascaping dice?
Oh my god.
So let's go to the third place. This is one from William, and I think this is very easy to pronounce.
William.
So, tell me, Bobby.
Yeah, for me that. You. Yeah, I. That tank it's on the in the place that they are, because it's very well done. I don't know in English that right now it's too late for me. So I love the way that the moss are on the boots. They have Cuba there, so you have. You don't have the end, you cannot see the end of the tank, so you don't know if so the pictures are very well done. I love the details on the front for sure. The microsorum are like, you know, needs time, that kind of plants here. Maybe he can put something extra or some butches or anubias, but that one, it was one of my top for sure. So I like that tank very much. It's so nice. I don't know how many tanks that William did before. Do you know him?
But that doesn't matter at all.
Now the contest is done. So the places are...
No, it doesn't matter at all. So he could have done this because... for the first time, or could be a very experienced one.
William, if you are there, how many...
I can notice one thing, that he did it very well, the homework. Because the way how he hides the back corners of the glass is not for someone that is starting. So look to the wood, the place of the wood, how it is placed somehow. And it is also disguising a little bit. It's disguising immediately the lines of that we have in the background and the corner of the tank. And that is gives endless depth to the tank. The only thing that I am missing is a little bit more of details. For example, the use of some bulbitis, also something that gives a little bit more a forest theme to the aquascape. I think this is what is missing a little bit on this layout. I like the way all the moss is placed, the different shadows and contrast on the greens, but for me, the still need a little bit on the details and working mostly on the naked wood that is pointing forward to the top or to the corners. Just adding a little bit, some bulbitis, something there that gives some kind of fern shape, I think will make a huge difference in the end.
I agree. Yeah.
Do you agree? Oh,
yeah.
So,
yeah.
So I already told everything. So it's you girls are taking part of everything that I'm saying. You should start first. I will be the last one. So let's go for the second one.
The okay, Rami.
Oh, Rami.
Okay, Benjamin.
Okay, the color in the bag is amazing. Yeah. Nice and red. And also the hardscape is cool. Very, I don't know how you say it, robust. Very, yeah.
Yeah, robust. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's full in a way that gives proper volume. Strong.
Yeah.
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 Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And the plants also look healthy. That's very important.
Yeah.
So, bubbly.
It's enough. It's enough. Yeah, for me, the best part in that one is the how the plants are on the place. You know, I think he didn't want to mix. So I think he did exactly what he wanted to do in that tank. So for sure, the way the plants are so healthy, the colors are amazing. You have different shapes, colors, and textures, and layers. For me, that is so important too. And for sure, I think it's so nice. I miss a little bit bigger, taller, taller the Rotala on the background, mm-hmm. and maybe I miss something on the left part, mm-hmm. because you have that mirror, but I think it's so nice. The tank, it looks bigger than the real size that it has in the reflection. I think it's nice.
But that is a trick, because I am a photographer, and also I'm quite used to submit tanks for a contest. However, I'm not doing for the last years. I think I did 2 years ago just to get back to the competition. But usually I prefer just to escape my tanks and share them. But in this way, I understand completely what Benjamin did by looking to the lines. It's just lower down the camera and take the picture down to up. And this is why you don't see that much the stem plants. Somehow, I think Benjamin, he already is submitting some tanks to some contest to YAPLC. And of course, this kind of tricks, how you place the camera just to shoot. And for example, I think this one was taken with a mobile phone, because when I was zooming it and trying to see, because we see on the right side that is on the moss, when we have the mix of the moss with the Monte Carlo, it seems like a big ball of algae. But it's not. It's kind of blur caused by the auto or the lack of focus on that area. And that is caused because you lower down so much the camera, just to lower the angle and take a picture from down to top. And you see for the lines, it's like the tank never ends. And also the idea of cover the corners and give a very strong focal point and a very strong V shape. This also makes this layout very, very special. The only thing that I am missing on this one is finishing the right side, right corner, because you see that I think his Drocotyl verticillata is still growing a little bit more. By adding a little bit of Eleocharis, just to mix a little bit, just to bring this more or less to the center, would make this layout super. But it's an amazing job. And also the use of the black background, I think somehow spot on all the colors, because we usually don't see that much black backgrounds in the contest. They always tend to be all white, like I have here, so we give more depth. But somehow he enhanced the color of all the reds and the greens. Congratulations, Benjamin. It's a really nice, nice one. So let's move to the first one, right? And here is Sven van Hermet. Is I think, guys, if we look to this tank, not knowing the size of it, do you think that is possible to make in a 40-30-30? And man, this layout, I think, was unanimous for most of the judge, because this one is definitely something that is completely different from all the others. There is a lot of sense of depth. The only thing that, if I need to be picky, is the shape of the three pieces of wood. Place it on the... Bless you!
Thank you.
The more or less the same shape we see replicated on the left side. You see more or less the same shape. Somehow it catch my attention. I don't know if that was on purpose or not, but all the details, how it is done, the vanishing point, the use of the stem plants, this one is amazing. Well done. Just one note, Sam, if you are seeing it, try to disguise that top of the wood on the left side. The cut, horizontal cut, should not be there. You should disguise it with something else or just cut it. Because we have all the lines like this and we have a cut. So, but in general, I have nothing more to say. So I will leave the girls saying something about this one. It was, I think, my first one. So I'm very happy that he won.
Yeah, we were four judges. I
voting in this one for the first.
Four judges. We did vote for me. Was the first one too. So I think you can see that it's very special because you have a lot of details. I love the way that you go to the background. Yeah, because he did it so well that it's no easy to do in a small tank. And for sure, I repeat all the time the same, but they have just 4 months to do it. So for sure, some plants needs more time. You can do some details, you can change something, but I love the way that the boot for the right part do like this, like twist and takes place. I think that for me, that part is one of the
from the right to the left and bring to the corner. I think that was very wise to do. Really, very wise to do. So, adding a little bit of taping twigs just to give a little bit more texture on the wood on the left.
Yeah,
that is an amazing job. And Romy, please, you are the last.
Sam was also my number one, and of course, you already said it, but a lot of depth by using finer materials in the back, finer plants in the back. The colors in the back are also very cool. I love the details in the front and the shadow on the right front. It's a really cool tank. Congratulations.
But
all the comments done, or shall we say something nice? No. So we already have comments. No, this is a joke. That can we say something nice? No.
Nope.
So we're going to now finish, of course, by thank you all for watching the live stream. Also,
Sam is here.
Also,
I think we have a lot of tips for you. So,
next Friday, if everything goes as scheduled, I'm going to review the 26 tanks. So including the top 10 again, probably you already have listened my opinion about the top 10. Probably I will be a little bit shorter than what I have explained, but all the 26 will be reviewed in depth, detail and everything. I really hope that you guys have enjoyed. Thank you for watching. And for all the contestants that I have seen live stream, one advice, don't take the critics that we are doing or the review to your tank as a personal. I don't think we said something wrong, but don't take it personal.
We look you all.
And kind of experience that can take you to improve the tanks in a better way. Because it's not our intention just to fear the sensibility of all of you. Or if you feel that we said something wrong, please accept our apologies. I think I can talk by Romy and also by Balbi. But the idea was trying to be more clear about what we think that can be improved. But always one thing that I have learned with all this time, if someone criticizes your work, it's not criticizing you, it's criticizing the tank. So you can listen and improve, or you can simply move your back and still doing what you really like to do. So take these opinions and reviews in the good side of the critic, and nothing and never personal, okay? Nope. So from my side, I will see you on Friday. So now we're going to have Romy. Do you want to say something to all of them?
To all the participants?
Oh, to everybody.
To all the people.
Okay, to everybody. Okay, thank you so much for watching. And I hope you liked the video. And see you soon. Maybe in real life, maybe online. We will see.
Okay. So, Babita.
Thank you very much. You know, I'm not shy, okay? You know me. All of you that you are here, you know me. But when I need to be serious and I need to talk in English, so for me it's a little bit difficult. And thank you very much to be here. I'm so happy, and I'm so happy for all of you because you did it so well. I just hope to see you soon in person. And a big kiss to all. Thanks for watching, and I miss you.
So,
you think that it's all?
From my side, guys, I'm going to see you all. No, you're going to see me on Friday if everything goes as planned. So I'm going to check all the 26 tanks and also trying to get some new footage about all my tanks and everything. Try to bring a few more content for all of you, because this video is also being published in my YouTube channel. Sorry for not commenting all the or showing the comments, but we have that time on Friday. So till then, I think I will just put all together over here and wish to everyone a really happy holidays. Stay safe, yeah. And looking forward to meet you somewhere, some events, some aquascaping, whatever. So we're going to see all around. So big kiss to all of you, mostly you ladies.
I love you guys.
And then guys,
I love you.
Don't leave yet, because we still have a video to show you.
Yes.
This is the top 10 again, and also with the message from Sam regarding his tank. Okay, so we are leaving. I will let you with the video and see you guys on Friday. Take good care of yourself. Bye-bye.
See you. Thanks for watching.
Hello everyone, I hope you're all doing well. This is my tank for Anak 2020. This year I tried to create a nature style layout with lots of wood and dark green plants. but I also wanted to infuse it with some with a lot of color and a lot of depth. So I combined it with a diorama style. In the background, I wanted to create a low-hanging sun in the back of a dark green forest, and I think it came out really nice. I used some different plants. I used Rotala, it's in the background, Colorata, Hara. I used some Lagenandra Meboldi and some other flashy plants, and also a lot of moss and green plants.